Hello everyone, welcome to our video. On this occasion, we would like to present our video presentation entitled Utilization of Saponins for Sapindus rarak and Making Rablet Soap. Before we start to the video, let me introduce myself and my group. My name is Teresa, Tania, Tamsil.
My name is Jesselyn, Laurencia.
My name is Josefina, Aurelia, Kurnia.
And we are from Trinitas Senior High School, Indonesia. So let's start the video. Here is our research preliminary or preface. Then here's the material roles of each material. Then the purpose of this soap is create awareness among the public about environmentally friendly natural soaps and to increase awareness of efforts to go green in the world, including reducing the problem of detergent waste. The benefit of this soap that the public can participate in increasing efforts to go green in the world and to introduce the public to the characteristics of soap that are commonly used and the procedures for making natural tempered soap. We conclude this framework of thinking from the preliminary and material rules. Here's the formulation of the problem that we use for this research. First, can the saponin content in rarak root be used as an ingredient for making soap and is not harmful to the environment? Second, how is soap produced? Is the soap more effective than other commercial soaps? Third, how does the soap impact the environment and the human body?
These are tools that we need for making rabbit soap. These are materials that we need for making rabbit soap. These are procedures for making rabbit soap.
Now, we will discuss about analysis of rabbit soap. First, analysis of fat solubility test. From this graph, it can be seen that the percentage of hand conditions when using rabbit soap is higher than using market soap. Then, analysis of clean speed test on rinsing. From this graph, it can be seen that when using market soap, it takes 16 seconds to make hands feel clean, while in rablet soap, it takes 30 seconds. So it can be concluded that the time used for washing rablet soap is 2 times longer when compared to market soap. Then, analysis of bacterial killing test. This is a table of bacterial killing test results data. We use 3 petri discs for this test, and we conclude the results in this graph. It can be concluded that rablet soap has a higher level of killing power against bacteria than market soap, because there are fewer bacteria found in the bacterial test media when using rablet soap. After that, here's the result we get that we got from the questionnaire. For example, there is a girl who weighs 58 kilograms and is 156 centimeters tall. From the graph, it can be seen that the girl can use 3 to 4 pieces of soap.
From the analysis, we can find the result and discussion. First, the saponin that contain in rarak can be used as an antimicrobial and antifungal. Second, rabbit soap contains rarak root, sodium hydroxide, coconut oil, and pandan leaves. Third, saponin in rarak also produces sufficient foam as needed. Fourth, based on the questionnaire, the soap is more practical to carry everywhere. Fifth, pandan leaves in soap as a soft texture, softener, and fragrance or deodorizer. Sixth, soap making is done through 4 stages. Seventh, based on bacterial test, hand using rarak soap are cleaner than commercial soap. Based on the analysis and data, we can conclude that the content of saponin in rarak root can be used as an ingredient for making rabbit soap with the help of coconut oil, sodium hydroxide, and pandan leaf extract. Second, the resulting is more effective than other commercial soaps. Third, based on the result of the questionnaire distributed, rabbit soap was 62.5% effective and able to cleanse their body. Fourth, as many as 100% of respondents who filled out the questionnaire, they agreed with the rabbit soap innovation. The advantages of rabbit soap are, first, for human life. It has a relatively small size, so it is practical when used and very efficient to carry everywhere, especially when traveling. Second, for human body. It can clean the human body truly without causing the slightest negative effect. So it can be concluded that this soap can be suitable for various skin types. Third, for environment. It is easier to decompose in nature, environmentally friendly, and can support the Go Green program. And it doesn't produce excessive foam, so it can pollute the aquatic ecosystem.
These are suggestions from our experiment for other researchers. First, in making rablet soap design, it is better to make a design that can make it easier for someone when using it, and so that the soap does not fall easily. Second, if rablet soap marketing is good, then rablet soap should be mass-produced. That's all from us. Sorry if there are mistakes. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and share.